Okay. So, hi everyone. My name is Huiren. I will be sharing a very quick lightning talk on my journey as a web developer. So just a show of hands, who here uses Twitter? Twitter? Anyone? Okay, a few number of people. If you're not on Twitter, it's time to get on Twitter. It's the new in thing right now. What about email? Anyone here uses email? All right. So if you don't use email, I don't know what you use, right? So my Twitter handle is there, Wuhiren, and hello at wuhiren.me. So I'll be giving a very quick overview of what I'm going to talk about. So six major things here. Who, what, when, where, why, and how, right? So these are the six things that I will be generally sharing in the talk itself. So first off, I'm just a very quick introduction of who I am. So my name is Huiren, 19 years old this year. So yeah, 19 years old, web developer, and a very open source advocate. I advocate about open source, open management, and open leadership, etc. So I really enjoy using open source software and contributing to open source software as well. And of course, I'm an open organization and Fedora ambassador in Singapore. So you might be wondering, what does an open organization ambassador do? All right. So what we do is we share stories, we tell stories about open leadership and open management and how it's changing the landscape in the industry itself. So big companies like Red Hat, Google, Facebook, they're adopting this open management kind of guidance style in their company and how it helps them adapt and quickly adjust to the changes in the tech itself. Because you know, tech is always a very fail fast and all sort of things, right? So other than that, as a Fedora ambassador, I help plan open source events, Document Freedom Day, which is one of the open standards events which we held this year, and also attend one conference here, FOSS Asia. Anyone heard of it, FOSS Asia? Okay, a few hands. Good, good. So FOSS Asia is an annual event that was held this year in Singapore, March, early March. So it focuses on free and open source development in Asia in general, right? So I went there and helped out. You can see there's some Fedora DVDs stick onto my body, right? All right, so enough talking about myself. So let me just dive straight into what my experience has been like. So I started programming, started web development at 13 years old. But before that, I really did some programming in general. And what really motivated me when I was young to really start programming was because I liked playing games. So games like MapleStory, Adventure Quest, and many more. These games are what I really enjoyed playing. And I want to do more than just play games. I want to create games. So I started off learning C, C++, and Java, and it was a disaster in general because it was a lot of things to learn. And I couldn't cope it quite well. And you know, I moved on, I pivoted and leaned towards web development and learned about it. So I was guided and mentored by a Ruby developer, right? So he doesn't know how to develop in PHP, but he still knows programming concepts, and he really mentored me about this kind of concepts, and he helped philosophies, and he had certain philosophy of programming. And he was one strange thing that he had was that he was against the philosophy of JSON. And that was quite a bit strange, I guess. But most of the time, I spend learning it on my own, picking up PHP on my own. And when I needed help, I approached him. And he was more than willing to help out. So as you can see, people are really helpful. Even as a stranger, a Ruby developer out there in the world, I communicated with him through something like an IRC. And you know, it was really, really nice of people out there. So around 16 years old, I started joining competitions, and you know, I used frameworks such as AngularJS, Laravel, and etc. Won some competitions, but I lost all the public ones. So the open competitions that was open to entire public, I didn't win any of them, right? So one of the competitions that was held was SIA App Challenge. It was a pretty interesting one. When I went for I did some development, and when I went for the pitching round itself, I saw people had like machine learning applications, and well, of course, I didn't make it to the top 10 either. But it was a very good experience where I learned a lot about design, failure, and many more things, and you know, when you fail, you do learn a lot of things, right? Take it as a learning opportunity, right? So when I was around 17, I started some projects. So I have this MPVPN project. It's like a VPN project based on soft ether VPN. Our school, I study in this polytechnic called Ngee Ann Poly. It's a local polytechnic here, and it does have a firewall that kind of blocks people from playing games and SSH and all that. So this project was set up to, you know, allow people to bypass this firewall and, you know, do stuff they wanted to that they couldn't previously. And I thought it was helpful, and people did thank me for that, I think. Anyway, so I also did some freelancing, blah, 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 learn more JavaScript. So, okay, so at a pivoting moment was when I was 18, I read this book called Open Organization. So this Open Organization book was written by a very famous guy. He's the CEO of Red Hat, Jim Whitehurst. He talked about his experience when he was in Delta Airlines. He was in a very bureaucratic structure, and he moved over to a more open structure in Red Hat, where he learned about that, you know, it can be messy, but things can still get done very quickly. And Red Hat proven that, you know, they can actually gather people to participate just because they had a very clear purpose. And purpose was something that motivated people, intrinsic motivations out there that really pushed people forward. And I was really inspired by people from the open source communities, very inspired by them, especially by Jim Whitehurst's book. And I was inspired to contribute as well. So, you know, I joined the Fedora Ambassadors, and of course joined the Fedora Open Organization Ambassadors, you know, with a mindset that, hey, you know, I want to take part in this as well. I want to do something to help, you know, maybe not change the world, but, you know, one step at a time. And of course, and when I was around 18, so same year, I met the communities within Singapore. It was a very vibrant community here in Singapore. We do have a very vibrant tech community, although there's not a lot of people here, but I think some of them can't make it down today. But, you know, it's a very vibrant tech community here in Singapore. And when I went for conferences, FOSS Asia and all, I met really passionate people and experienced people there. And they were really open and shared their knowledge with me, shared their experience. When I asked questions, they were really willing to help out. So in general, the communities are very friendly out there. And of course, some of the photographs here with Darwin. He's the founder of CyroWorks, which is a smart fridge company. Yeah, this was at one of the conference called Echelon. And this was at a meetup at Google. It was a Git meetup where, you know, you can see Michael down there and a few other tech people down there. So yeah, it's a really vibrant community. So talking about, you know, taking in so much invaluable knowledge that I've gained from the community, right? I've also wanted to give back to the community that has actually helped me grow to me right here today. If without the community, without the Open Organization book, I wouldn't be here today sharing with you my experience, right? So I want to give back to the community. I plan open source events, as you can see, Document Freedom Days, and some other events as well, Fedora Release Party, and also I want to share my knowledge when I go for meetups, right? I give talks. So I know I might not be a prominent speaker, like I might not be working in Akamai, I might not be working in a very big company, you know, I might not be a 10-year experienced PHP developer and all, but I believe that anyone and every one of us in this room right here can contribute to open source if we want to do it. So we can help people around us if we want to do it. And of course, I also help out having some workshops that were free to help people gain more knowledge about the web development itself. And yeah, so this is a photo of Engineers.SG at PyCon this year. So you can see there's a few of us here. So Engineers.SG is one of the group here started by Michael as well. So what we do is we go to meetups and conferences to document and record meetups and conferences so that people get to watch these videos, which they can't if they couldn't attend the meetup or anything, and you can even reach out to the global community in general. Yeah, so it's a very meaningful course. And if you're interested in joining Engineers, do talk to Michael. He can help you out. And of course, other than that I do have some open source projects, such as the Open Healthcare project. It's a software which allows people, which allows patients and doctors to share information with each other. And of course, the Open Fish project, which allows, which prevents ghost gears in the sea itself. So let me just conclude my entire experience, okay? So with some lessons that I've learned throughout my entire experience as a PHP developer, right? So, you know, one thing that I really learned from the OpenMRS people was that code can change lives. So OpenMRS is Open Medical Record System. So they came down to FOSS Asia and I talked to them a little bit, and their software was used by many people in the African countries, developing countries as well, where they can't afford expensive healthcare software, and they use OpenMRS. And this software is used to save and change lives, especially in the medical area. So one thing that I really learned was that, you know, code can change lives. You know, every single line of code we write here can really change lives. And one not so good thing is that drugs do exist in the world, right? The world is not perfect. You know, there's always good and bad things, right? So one of not so good things was when I went for a meetup and I talked to this guy, and he told me that, you know, I told him that I was a Fedora ambassador, which I was a volunteer for Fedora project, and it was a project under Red Hat, right? So he told me that, oh, you're just a person who works for Red Hat for free. Why don't you work at some other company like Facebook and Yahoo for free? I heard Yahoo's closing down. So I felt pretty insulted by those kind of statements. So yeah, some people like that do exist in the world, right? But of course, nice people do exist, you know. People like Michael, people like CJ, people like Zion. We share knowledge with each other, you know, through tech meetups and many more. We learn from each other, and good or bad experiences is still a learning opportunity for each of us. And other than that, you know, since good and bad people exist, we want to choose who we mingle with, right? Choose who we try to mingle with, the good ones. And of course, when we come to the tech communities, there's a lot of opinions thrown at me when I first came in. People say, like, oh, PHP sucks. PHP, you should use this instead. You should go for Node. You should use Go. You should blah, blah, blah. So, you know, keep an open mind and try to understand it from their perspective. Try to understand where they're coming from. Why do they say something like that, right? Everyone have their reason for why they say something, right? So try to keep an open mind and don't get and of course it's a take and give thing. When you take from when I take some so much invaluable knowledge shared by the tech communities, by so many people of you that right here, just in the conference itself, I learned so much from all the speakers, and of course taking knowledge from them is a great thing. So I want to give, you know, we should all give back our give back and contribute wherever we can. So, for example, if we use open source software, we should, of course, contribute back to the open source community, right? So, just that's really it for my talk. I hope you enjoy it. So, if you want to ping me up on Twitter, that's my Twitter handler. And if you want to drop me an email or catch me up later afterwards. All right, so do we have time for questions, or do we... All right, so thank you.